been difficult, but I got a job to do, and that's it. That's just been focusing on the job, really. You know, I haven't been thinking about being away from this and being from that. I've just been focusing on the job and just getting the job done. Obviously, last time I lost, so I've been in limbo with the job, so it's just a continuous training camp, really. It's been frustrating because obviously I got ready for him twice already, and he delayed the fight once because he said he needed more time to prepare, and the second time he said he had COVID, which is really mysterious because there was no evidence of him ever having COVID or nothing. We requested evidence and after we didn't get no evidence. If he had COVID, then I'm wrong for saying he didn't or whatever, and I'll put my hands up to it. But if he didn't have COVID, then is it?
Yeah, it sounded like, well, I actually felt like that from the jump. As soon as they said Povetkin had COVID, it was so convenient. I was expecting that to get announced at some point. I knew he wasn't going to. That was ridiculous for him to step right into the rematch immediately after taking such a beating. Of the, like people say, knockouts cause amnesia. People seem to forget that he took licks in that fight. He was getting whooped. He was about to get taken out. He just threw like one last final. That was his last hurrah. His last hurrah took Dillian out. So, yeah, he still needed time to recover. Or, you know, other things might be at play. Which I reckon Dillian is really trying to insinuate other things. Which, yeah, he might be right. Other things could be at play. But, yeah, it is what it is. Dillian, Povetkin had COVID. They're saying he went down to cruiserweight level. He got all the way down to 200 pounds, but we still ain't seen, no pictures, we ain't heard nothing. I'm surely someone got a picture somewhere of Povetkin looking 200 pounds. So I'm personally not buying it. I kind of agree with Dillian. How can you not show not even a shred of evidence? Dillian said he still hadn't seen not a single document, nothing to prove that he actually did have COVID. So yeah, I'm not buying it myself. It's either one of the two. He either needed time to recuperate, or, you know, Povetkin just, you know, doing what he does.
So I just wanted to just get in there and put the wrong right straight away and just get on. You know, obviously, you know, it's not like I was getting outclassed. I was getting, you know, so it's just one of those where it's heavyweight boxing. People get caught with punches and they get rocked and they get knocked out. So, you know, I just wanted to get straight back in, really, you know. But there's a time when we thought about looking at other fights, but then I was like, no. I want to fight Povetkin. I wait for him. It doesn't matter. I wait. I make sure. That's like my statement. I said, listen, I wait and I make sure he's healthy and he's fit and he's strong and ready to go, and I'll fight him again. I was busting a fight, you know, obviously switched off for a second, and you got caught as a weight boxing, you know, these things happen, you know, but it ain't damaged me in any way mentally or physically. This is boxing, man. Muhammad Ali got beaten, you know, the greatest of all time, Sugar Robinson, you know, these guys, they all get stopped, it's normal, they all get beaten, you know, it's boxing, man. Boxing is like a game of gambling, you know, you might roll straight sixes all the time, and then, you know, just sometimes you just roll straight ones or whatever. It just so is. It's like life, you know. You don't win everything in life. Not every day you wake up in life and you're so positive and you're jumping around.
I do think he's capable of, well, I gave my prediction already. I'm going to do a revised one closer to the fight. I do think he's capable of beating it. It's not going to be easy whatsoever, but it can be easy. I wouldn't be shocked if he makes easy work of Povetkin. And I wouldn't be shocked if Povetkin won again. Even though my prediction is Dillian to win. Povetkin is a live dog. Povetkin's no joke, you know. Guy's an assassin. You saw the way he just walked off after he did his job. Just laid the guy clean out and walked off. You know, no crazy celebration. Actually, you know, I take that back. That was the most emotional I've ever seen Povetkin after a fight. He kind of did a little bit of celebration after the fact. Immediately after he knocked him out, he was very calm about it. But about, say, a minute later, when his trainers and the rest jumped on, he looked very happy. That was the most emotion I've seen him show. The guy is usually just stone cold.
Listen, I'm going to get the win. I'm going to get the win in style anyway, so...
That's the way you'd be looking at it. You'd be looking at a summer fight with AJ or Fury or anything.
Yeah. But right now I'm just focusing on Povetkin because, you know, I was fully focused on him last time and I still lost. So, you know, people was like, oh, was he overlooking? I was like, no, dude, I was focused. I was focused on the fight. I was prepared for the fight. I was ready to go. You know what I mean?
So, I mean, is there a... But is there anyone on you still on your head? I mean, Deontay Wilder still is obviously still.
No, none of these fights. I'm just focusing on Povetkin, man. You know, he's a good fighter. As he showed last time, he's still got a lot left in the tank, and he's a dangerous guy. You know what I mean? But you know, I'm just focused. I'm definitely going for the knockout this time, 100%.
So if you get him in the same situation again, you'll be.
All hell will break loose if I knock him down again this time. Trust me, 100%. All hell will break loose.
I'm sure he knows he can't go all gung ho with Povetkin because, yeah, the guy's dangerous, like I said. If hell's going to break loose, you've got to be measured about it as well, Dillian. I do believe he should have pressed the action a bit more when he had Povetkin hurt and looking crazy for about maybe 2 to 3 rounds. Povetkin was there for the taking. From the second knockdown, Povetkin looked ready to go, so Dillian should have jumped on him. That's what I reckon anyway. It was boxing a bit too much for me. So yeah, I'm with all hell breaking loose, but measured. You gotta be measured about it. So if he hurts him again, definitely go for it. As usual, thoughts in the comment section below. If you're new here, subscribe, obviously, notification bell, click that, alert and all that good stuff. Don't forget to leave your predictions, thoughts on Povetkin, Dillian, everything, comment section below. And yeah, I'm out.